reptiles, they are the giant land vertebrates once upon a time. Reptiles are true land vertebrates. They ruled the entire world in once upon a time. They are dinosaurs. Reptiles are true land vertebrates. They are poikilothermic. Poikilothermic means they are cold-blooded animals. They can change their temperature according to their environment. That is called cold-blooded animals. Tetrapods means they are having the forelimbs and hind limbs. Reptiles are evolved from labyrinthodont amphibians in Carboniferous period. Mesozoic era is the golden age of reptiles, in which the dinosaurs are evolved in a peaked condition. The study of reptiles is called herpetology. The extinct giant reptiles are called dinosaurs. You can see the Jurassic parts where you can have the picture of dinosaurs. Reptiles are creeping or burrowing or cold-blooded animals. And cold-blooded animals means they can change their temperature according to the environment. The air breathing, they can take air from surroundings. Oviparous, they are egg-laying. Tetrapods means they are having forelimbs and hind limbs. Limbs are pentadactyl. Here you can see the limbs have having five parts, and each part is having the claws. Limbs are completely absent in the case of snakes. Skin is dry, carnified, and lacking glands. Elementary canal starts with the mouth and ends with the anus. Endoskeleton is bony. Skull is monocondylic. That means it shows only single occipital condyle. The respiration by lungs, only ribs are helpful in expansion and contraction in trunk region. Heart is highly evolved. Heart is highly evolved, and it is four-chambered with two auricles and two incompletely divided ventricles. Crocodiles have four-chambered heart like mammals and birds. Renal portal system is completely absent. RBCs are oval, biconvex, and nucleated, whereas 12 pairs of cranial nerves are seen, but in the case of snakes, only 10 pairs of cranial nerves are seen, one of the characteristic feature of Ophidia. External ear is absent. Middle ear shows only a single ear ossicle called columella oris. Nictitating membrane is seen in eyelids, which gives protection to the eye. Jacobson's organs are present, meant for smell. Kidneys are metanephric, that means highly evolved kidneys are seen. Land animals are ureotelic, that means their main excretory product is uric acid. Whereas aquatic animals, they are ureotelic, that means they excrete urea, and ammonotelic means they excrete ammonia. Urinary bladder may be present. Sexes are separate. Males have copulatory organ, but in the case of Spinodon, it is present in New Zealand, in which the copulatory organs are completely absent. Fertilization is internal. That means here the fertilization occur inside of the body. Oviparous means they are egg laying. Eggs are highly accumulated in the yolk. That's why they are called megalocystal, covered with leathery shell. 4 embryonic membranes are seen. They are amnion, chorion, allantois, and yolk sac. That's why both reptiles, mammals, and birds are collectively called as amniotes, whereas fishes and amphibians are called anamniotes. Anamniotes means in which the embryonic membranes are absent. But in the case of the reptiles, birds, and mammals, the embryonic membranes are present. That's why they are called amniotes. Whereas the amphibians and the fishes are called anamniotes. They are devoid of metamorphosis. No metamorphosis is seen in the case of reptiles. Parental care is absent. Ecdysis is seen in snakes and lizards. They can shed their scales and other external parts. That is called ecdysis or molting. This is the general features of reptilia. Thank you, one and all.